make some noise for the Kyles. Kyle Miner and Kyle Stonehouse, canoe number 7, making their way towards a 7th place finish at the 2021 Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Kyle Miner, Kyle Stonehouse. Hey, congratulations, gentlemen, on a fine race. Very fast time, too. The two Kyles in at number 7. Congratulations, and yep, we've got another canoe coming around the bend already. Congratulations. Hey, we have had 7 finishers already in all. Extremely fast times. Coming around the bend, we have a former champion. This is canoe number 2, making its way toward the finish line. A former champion, 58-year-old Brett Stockton, and 34-year-old Ryan Halstead. A couple of past champions making their way towards the finish line.
Good job, Kyle.
And our 8th canoe. Sponsors include CRE and FallTheDarkness.com and 98.5 UPS. Brett is a 9-time winner. And he is going to cross that finish line in 8th place. They are sponsored by Anderson Windows. He's a sales rep with them out of Bay City. Brett Stockton, 58. Ryan, a DT Energy technician out of Grayling. Number of starts, 14 for each. And as I mentioned, they are former champions. And they are coming to the finish line. Canoe number 2, former champions Brett Stockton and Ryan Halstead have a top 10 finish coming their way. Congratulations, former champions,
9-time
champion Brett Stockton and former champion Ryan Halstead. Congratulations on your 8th place finish at the 73rd annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
8th place, way to go, guys. Great finish.
Hey!
Well, this is an awesome thing to do to see Brett Stockton come in after all these years.
We've got a couple of canoes coming around the bend. Canoe number 13. That is Nick Walton, 48, of Eaton Rapids, and Serge Paget.
Great job, Brett. Way to go, bud.
24 from St. Boniface, Quebec.
Whoop.
But right ahead of canoe
number
13. Deep here.
Yeah,
that's pretty deep.
There, you want a hand?
We've got a real race for Matt Walton. Just ahead of canoe number 13. That is canoe number 66.
Good job. Good job. Way to go.
That is Patrick
nice finish.
And Steve Watson, as they come toward the finish line. It looks like
Ryan Halstead, Brett Stockton.
Canoe number 66. Patrick Madden, 41, of New York. Steve Watson of Ottawa. Our 9th place canoe, and right after that, canoe number 13, our top 10 finish.
We're going to have to keep getting out of here quick, because they're going to start piling in.
Canoe number 66, 41-year-old Patrick Madden from Scotia, New York, and 49-year-old Steve Watson of Ottawa. Their best finishes were 9th and 6th, respectively. They are going to get a 9th place finish, just ahead of our 10th place. Our 10th place canoe, again, 48-year-old Nick Walton and 44-year-old Serge Paget from Quebec, Canada. Nick from Eaton Rapids. They are our 10th place canoe. Fast and furious as they come around there. 10 canoes in so far. We probably got at least another 70 to go, but we'll be here right till the end. My name's Kevin Allen from Carroll Broadcasting's WKJC. We are part of the Canoe Marathon Radio Network. And playing the pitch course is Rex Mann.
Good job, Steve.
Patrick, what do you need, bud? Good job, Serge.
What? Good job. Well, there's your top 10, everybody.
Here. 2 minutes.
Oh, Patrick, that rock.
I'm going to come back in a minute with a flip my phone upside right.
Grayling, here they come. Danny and Ian, ready to take that checkered flag. Congratulations, Ian and Danny, on your 11th place finish at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Congratulations, gentlemen. We have 11 canoes in the booth. You guys now have some stretching and some massaging coming your way from Renew Physical Therapy. And maybe by the end of this, I'll need that. Rex Manning,
great job, Danny. Way to go.
And we're glad you're out here. We're glad to be back with you at Finish Line Park in Oscoda for the Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
Eleventh place, Danny Medina. Everybody's getting rejuvenated here. These guys put a lot on the line for this race. Record breakers out front.
We're gonna
try and stay live here for a while. Todd Vandeven, big time feeder here at the Canoe Marathon, paddler also.
Come on, you got to paddle faster than that if you want to make it to the finish line.
You got the Colin Hunter team, Deuce Deuce, hanging out here in the shoot area. Danny Medina and his partner.
Let's give them a big hand. Here they come on the finish line. Woo! Take that checkered flag. Don't look any worse for the wear after 14 plus hours of paddling. Nice job.
Have a recreational canoe coming across the finish line, getting a cheer.
Around the bend, Profiles Hair Designs, Paddle Hard Brewery, Oscoda Septic, Oscoda CBB, Northland Area Federal Credit Union, The Medicine Shop, Kodiak Group, Instacode, Huntington Bank, and Hart Motors. Again, my name's Kevin Allen from Terrell Broadcasting's WKJC. We are part of the Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon Radio Network, and our presence out here, Hits FM, I'm Brad, broadcasting live at the finish line, and of course you can find us at hitsfm.net. And coming around the bend, our 12th canoe, paddling hard for home, that is canoe 22. I see some 22 people out there for sure. That is 43-year-old Jason Hatfield from Grayling and 40-year-old Colin Hunter, also from Grayling, It's another All-Michigan team. They are also an All-Masters team and Iron Paddlers, too. Here they come. They are sponsored by AuSable Chiropractic Clinic in Mayo, an Old Dam Party Store, Jason, a Crawford County Road Commissioner, and as for Colin, he's a judge. But today, they're paddlers. Best finishes have been 8th place for both of them. And they're big Metallica fans. So we might as well have some Metallica for you. You guys come across the finish line. Our 11th canoe to cross. This is canoe number 22. Jason Hatfield and Colin Hunter. Our 12th canoe across the finish line. Congratulations, Jason and Colin, taking the checkered flag on a terrific race. Congratulations. A dozen canoes are across. We'll be here until that 80th canoe crosses the finish line again. Thank you to some more of our contributing sponsors. AuSable Live Care, AuSable Hardware, Century 21 of Grayling, Charlie's Country Corner, CSI Emergency Apparatus, the Deer Bear Brewery, Du Bois Lumber, Beanie Board, Gary Oil, and Grayling Visitors Bureau. And again, my name's Kevin Allen from Carol Broadcasting. We are part of the radio network and playing the tunes for you. Rex Manning, sent on the fence by Rex. Give him a call at 736-9564.
We're here at the AuSable Inn. Nice restaurant. Good food. Encourage you to have a bite to eat there when you come into town. If you've seen the shower, Brent, have him get me a hot dog. I'm calling
the man. The showers with Roseanne would be nice.
Okay.
Watch out!
Jason's hands are pretty tore up.
Okay, we do have an unofficial canoe making their way towards the finish line, but right behind them,
it's going to be
our 13th canoe across the finish line.
We told them,
Lucky number 13, those are brothers out there, canoe number 78. That is Michael and Benedict Schlimmer making their way toward the finish line. They are sponsored by Lynn and Randy Thompson of Grayling and Zavril Racing Equipment. Michael, 35, is a software engineer out of Portland, New York. Benedict, 32, also a software engineer, and he's out of Camillus, New York.
Anybody want some chocolate milk?
And both of them are Iron Paddlers, so they are coming home. They have done this before. They will be our 13th canoe across the finish line. Michael, 35. Benedict, 32. Couple of brothers paddling together. Who said anything about sibling rivalry? These guys are doing great. They will be our 13th canoe to cross the finish line. To make a lot of noise for them, here they come. A couple of New Yorkers, Michael and Benedict Schwimmer, heading toward the finish line. as our 13th canoe to cross the finish line. Michael and Benedict Sliver, congratulations on finishing 13th at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. And right behind them will be our first mixed canoe. That is canoe number one making their way toward the finish line. It's another slipper.
First mixed team
we
coming
have
in.
Number one, Richard Roth of Gros Eel, Michigan, and Mary Sliver of Traverse City. Here they come. They are sponsored by Savro Racing Equipment and 98.5 UDPS.
Good job, guys.
Best finishes have been eight.
Good job. Good job, Mike, Ben. Way to go. Good job. Nice race.
So our first female crossing the finish line, make a lot of noise. There we go. Canoe number one, Richard Watt, the design engineer out of Gros Eel 48. Mary, a minion wrangler out of Traverse City. Congratulations on your 14th place finish.
Brother Mike.
The AuSable River Canoe Marathon, and Mary being the first
Mary
woman to cross the finish line. Congratulations.
Strong, right behind her brothers, Ben and Mike.
AuSable River Canoe Marathon record set 13:54.09, breaking the record that was set 27 years ago. So far, all of our times have been very fast. We have got 14 canoes across the finish line.
Nice job, Rich. Way to go. Good race.
They got a booth set up right over here. Pick up some nice, they got some cool things over there. And you can get your picture taken there, too. I didn't get time to get my picture taken. But you can go over there, get your picture taken at the Consumers Energy booth. Our gold paddle sponsor, Munson Healthcare, Grayling Hospital. And our bronze paddle sponsors, F&B Operations and Resource Management, Grayling Generating Station, Matt LaFontaine Automotive, Sons, Fisher Contracting, and Northbound Outfitters. Product and media sponsors, our good friends from 98.5 UPS, and of course, Hits FM 103.3 and 94.9, Carroll Broadcasting, a part of the radio network. My name's Kevin Allen from WKJC. I'll be out here right in the
first
last
mixed
canoe.
Team, Mary Schlimmer, Richard Law. Great
you're
job.
Today. Sound effects by Rex. Thank you very much.
Washing his beard?
Yeah, he's washing his beard. Dumb, man.
Got a great crowd here. This is where the boats get taken and the GPS's get removed. We got a boat cleaning station over there, and they're relaxing under the shade. Got a few tents here. Northeast Canoe tent rental. Belle Flora, I'd like to thank her for all she does for all the community, including the AuSable, the Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Kind of looking for consumers rep. Got some interviews going on. Got Ryan Matthews, our statistician, everybody knows.
The most amount of teams that match on a
whenever you want to know something, that's who you ask. No, but the championship cup in front of Matt Meersman, record breaker, along with Jordan Wakely. An epic day here at the Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
Do you mind going back there?
Great job again, Jordan.
Thank you.
Uplifting day for them guys. Hey, would you give me a hamburger or something? Or a hot dog? I don't want to stand in line.
You got cash?
All right, ladies and gentlemen,
my pants are in the trailer. In that,
across the finish line at the 73rd annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
Box, back.
Their way down.
Yeah, dig in
there's
there.
There's a guy in there doing pretty
that
bad.
Is the new number.
Well,
I think they got an ambulance on the way for
it. Oh, that's the 90s over there. I love it. That is 21-year-old
Austin Weiler of Ross. We got a recovery tent over here. Kyle Stonehouse. I'd like to thank all the volunteers and everybody that helps out on with those that push it as hard as they can. I know them guys gave it 100%. Left nothing on the river.
Toward the finish line, our 15th canoe to cross the finish line. Let's make some noise for them. 29-year-old Austin Weiler from Roscommon and 39-year-old Adam Jelenis from Massachusetts. 15th canoe to cross the finish line.
Hey Josh, good to see you.
How's it going, Justin?
That was a great race today, eh?
Oh, it was a really good race.
Did you follow along?
I followed some Connors and I went home and then I came back at 5 chances.
Nice, nice. Well, it was awesome having a record-breaking year. That's cool, you know, and having a couple of guys, first-time winners and record-breakers.
Exactly.
So, good seeing you.
Yeah, you too.
Nicole and Matt, they've been my eyes and ears today, making sure we get the right canoes as they come in. They're from the Ham Radio Club and also from Hungry Howard. So thank you to them for doing such great work for us. But we are going to be here until we get that last
We got Austin Weiler.
Team
90, great job, guys. Great job.
River Canoe Marathon Radio Network.
Got Phil Weiler back there, longtime volunteer, committee member, and media guy. He's does a lot for the Canoe Marathon. It's an honor for him to watch his son finish such a great race with a great time. It's a beautiful day here at the Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Nice watching the competitors talk about their journeys together after the race. Everybody pretty much misses each other throughout the night.
Yeah, buddy. I'm gonna go sleep.
Mary and her brothers, Ben and Mike. Great finish for the family. It's a great day for them.
No, not that.
A lot of smiles today. A lot of people happy with their times. A lot of teams turned in their best time this year. A little help from the rain and the river. But hey, that's they all signed up at the same time, not knowing what the water conditions were going to be. And that was our course for the night. And it was a great course, fast times. The rain held off for the start. A few hours before the start, it was just a beautiful, wonderful race here at the Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
Like, all right, we'll wait for a bit. Just
right.
Yeah, we finished that like that long trail away, turned around, expected to see something. There's no way.
Yeah. Who? Well, right on. Well, I'm not sure.
Like,
the last time we saw them, yeah, last time we saw them, how would that be? Hey, you guys got some life jackets in there? You want to show the postcard?
We just couldn't get that climb. It was just like survival at that point.
The Oscoda cheerleaders are doing some shuffling tonight. I must really like that one.
Quick question.
Yeah.
By the way, is it by donation?
So those guys stopped me and asked me. They said something about the boats didn't have the proper stuff and who to talk to.
They're gonna show them where they are.
Of course, canoe number 63, the first one across, again set a record 13:54.
No, they got them in there. They're showing them.
The second canoe across, number 99, did it in 14:07.
I told them you got to talk to General.
97, the third place canoe, 14:11:01. Fourth place, number 55, 14:11. Canoe number 8, 14:15:51. And then canoe number 52 was 14:17:33. And they were the 2, 3, 4, 5, 6th place canoe. Seventh was number 7 in 14:24:43. Then 14:26:26 for canoe number 2. Canoe number 66 was 14:27.
I'm
going to
run up and grab a charger real quick and hopefully stay with everybody. Having some fair luck with the internet, so that's good.
Canoe number 78, 14:43.
Show you guys a little bit of the concessions and nonprofits.
We've had some fast times so far.
Providing something for the fans to look at, mingle, and shop.
By Rex. Again, you can check him out at 736-9564. He is providing all the sound for us. We're at finish line for the 75th Annual Consumers Energy Couronne River Canoe Marathon.
My charger here. So they're going to start coming in packs. So if the things happen like they were last night, and we should be seeing groups of 10 come in shortly, close to each other. Hold that for a second. Just like that. They're always going to plug into it. Hang on, everybody. I'm getting charged up. Thank you. All right, we should have plenty of juice now.
So Adam just kept on like pushing
Phil and son Austin sharing memories on this great race. I'd like to thank the Oscoda High School football team. They're the official shoot crew.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, our 16th canoe. Spin it out of the bend and heading toward the finish line. That is canoe number 20. It's an all-Michigan canoe, a master's team at that, and iron paddlers, too. Canoe number 20 is Russ Reeker, 57, from Lapeer, and Tad Hill, 43, from Livonia. Tad had a fourth-place finish. His best finish is fourth, ninth. For Russ, they are sponsored by Penrod's Canoe and Kayak. Russ, 57, is a process engineer, Tad an engineer. They are making their way toward the finish line. They will be the 16th team to cross the finish line, just ahead of another canoe coming around the bend. But let's get Russ Reeker and Tad Hill across that finish line. Russ from Lapeer and Tad from Livonia. They've got themselves a top 20 finish. Here they come, canoe number 20. Russ and Tad, an all-Michigan team and a master's team. Congratulations, gentlemen, on your 16th place finish at the 73rd annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. And right behind them is another all-Michigan team. Canoe number 17, that is canoe number 30. Some 30s out there. That's Eric Badway from Grayling and Mike Bradford from Lapeer. They are sponsored by Grayling Restaurant and McLean and Son Contracting. And I believe this will be our first senior team to cross the finish line. Eric, 58, and Mike, 56. Eric is a retired Air Force colonel. Thank you for your service, my friend. And Mike is a carpenter. Best finish, sixth for Mike, 20th. For Eric, he's going to improve that. Here they come, canoe number 30. Eric and Mike, congratulations on your 17th place finish at the 73rd annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Go get a muscle stretching and a massage from Canoe Therapy. And thank you again, retired Air Force Colonel Eric Batway, for his service. Canoe number 30th, our 17th canoe across the finish line. Again, thank you to our title sponsors, Consumers Energy. Make sure to stop by their booth. We got the cheerleaders from Oscoda. We got the class of 2023. Sean Clark is here. We got this Heritage Rowing and Sailing. And the Oscoda Lions are here, too. They are selling raffle tickets. So if you're up and about in between, make sure to take in all of those and get your souvenirs, too. Hey, it's been 2 years since we were last here, so pick up a souvenir of the 2021 Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. And again, thanks to my good friend, Sound Effects by Rex. Official time for canoe number 20, 14:59:48. And canoe number 30, our first one to make it to the 15-hour mark, 15 hours and 42 seconds. So congratulations again on some very fast time. My name's Kevin Allen from WKJC's Carroll Broadcasting. We are a part of the Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon Radio Network. The guy's been working with me since day one. Sound Effects by Rex, playing the music and the sound today.
Leave it. No.
A lot of families involved in canoe racing. That was Bob Bradford, talking to Eric Batway there. And he paddled with his son, Mike Bradford. Great team.
A lot of cheerleader line dancers are out on the bridge. If you want to see some action, come on over here and see them too. This one was a special request for them. They are doing a great job. Very talented. I'll be putting that to use when the new season starts.
Trying to track down my hamburger. We got Larry Roberts doing an interview. Great, the mouth of the AuSable. The voice of the AuSable, sorry. With 98.5 UPS. Hey, good to see you.
Hey, how are you?
Good to see you.
Me too.
If you see Brent Lee anywhere, he's supposed to get me a hamburger like 20 minutes ago.
Still waiting.
I'm looking for him. I'll be down there. Thanks. Hey, Johnny. Jay. You want to hold this for a second? All right, well, go for it. I'm gonna take a quick break, get something to eat, and I'll be back again. Thank you everybody for watching the Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Great race, huh?
Oh, it was fast. Good race.
Yep.
Congratulations, Doug and Brad. You are 18th canoe to cross the finish line. Congratulations on finishing the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. And again, thank you to our title sponsor, Consumers Energy, the gold panel sponsor, Munson Healthcare, Grayling Hospital, and to our bronze panel sponsors, F&B Operations, Grayling Generation Station, Thick & Sons, by Matt, LaFontaine Automotive, Northbound Outfitters, and Fisher Contracting. And to all of our other fine sponsors too, Again, my name's Kevin Hanlon from Carroll Broadcasting's WKGC. Providing the sound for us is Sound Effects by Rex.
Canoe number 18 in 18th place. That's pretty cool. Great race for them guys. We're looking looking to go top in the top 20 here. We heard earlier that Jeff and Naomi were running 20th. Jeff Kolka and Naomi Kolka. Uncle and niece combo. Jeff, many time winning champion here at the Consumers Energy Assembly.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, our 19th canoe to cross the finish line is paddling hard toward that checkered flag, and it's going to be our second mixed team. Yeah, and it's a former champion, too. This is canoe number 16. Former champion Jeff Polka, 62 from Grayling, 21 starts. He is a past champion, and paddling along with him, Naomi Kolka, a paralegal, 25 from Grayling, her best finish is 39th. They're going to do much better than that. It'll be our second mixed team across the finish line, and another all-Michigan team. They are sponsored by Kuyu. 62-year-old Jeff Kolka, former champion. Self-employed from Grayling, and Naomi Kolka, paralegal from Grayling, 25. They will have a top 20 finish. Let's give a big round to a former champion, Jeff Kolka and Naomi Kolka. Uncle and niece taking that checkered flag. Congratulations to the Kolkas, Jeff and Naomi, on your top 20 finish at the 73rd annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
Top 20 finish.
Former
remarkable.
Jeff Kolka and a niece. Now that's something special. Uncle and niece finishing number 19.
Good job, Jeff. Way to go.
Thank you.
Way to go.
Ah, beautiful job, man. Oh. Woo! Thank you. So cool. 15, thank you. Thank you. Round there. 15 and a half.
Oh, baby.
I got to go again. Get in there, Jeff. Go, buddy. Good job.
All right, Lori, who we talked to earlier from the Oscoda High School class of 2023, said there's
19.
All the baked goods for the Oscoda class of 2023, two for a dollar.
Hey, Naomi, good job. Good job. Way to go.
All the baked goods there are two for a buck, so get some sweet treats as you're out here enjoying the 73rd annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
I have to stop.
Remarkable finish for these two.
Thank you.
I showed up like I waited 3 hours for my food and it was over.
So we're still looking for number 20. We just had 19 come in. Jeff and Naomi Kolka. Great job for them too. Jeff's complimenting Naomi on her skills last night. She's a good, great paddler, putting a lot of time in. Uncle Jeff wouldn't give her a chance unless she really meant business, and they proved it today, that's for sure.
Yes,
it was everything
that
I could hope for. We had two goals. Well, I had two goals. We had top 20 in under 16 hours. I think we hit both. So, and that was my dream to paddle with him. I've been saying since I was 7 years old that I was going to paddle the marathon with my uncle Jeff someday. Everybody was like, oh, okay,
Naomi,
yeah, and then it actually happened.
So. All right, we are getting ready to round up the top 20. Our 20th canoe is spinning around the bend and heading straight away towards home. That is canoe number 3. Oh, we got some 3s out here. There we go. That is 42-year-old Mo Harwood Jr. from Grayling. And 39-year-old Eric Pajeski of Grayling, making their way toward the finish line. They are sponsored by LaFontaine Automotive and Ferry Automotive Service and Transmission. It's an all-Michigan team. This one's just for you guys. Mo's an installer of everything, so if you need something installed, Mo can do it. Eric is a Grayling employee for the city. As for Mo, his best finish is a second. As for Eric, his best finish in eighth. But he hasn't raced since 2012. Here they come, another all-Michigan team. That's canoe number 3, rounding out our top 20 and paddling toward home. 42-year-old Mo Harwood Jr. and 39-year-old Eric Pajeski, both of Grayling, ready to take the checkered flag. Here they come. Yeah! Mo and Eric, congratulations on your top 20 finish of the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Woo! 20 canoes in the book, and that one's just for you guys. Some sugar on it. Hey, thanks to Nicole and Matt. They are Hungry Howie's employees, but today they are my eyes and ears. They are from the amateur radio group. They are doing an awesome job for us today. They are here in memory of our good friend Anton Orso. I worked with him for many, many years. Passed away earlier this year. Anton was a really good guy.
Great race, Mo. Well, great race.
All right, we've got another one coming around the bend. All right, well, this one's an all-Massachusetts canoe. This is canoe number 80, heading toward home. That will be our 21st canoe. Oh, we got to make some noise for this because this will be our first rookie to cross the finish line. 58-year-old Kevin Moss. This is his first ever race. Awesome. 58-year-old Kevin Moss and 49-year-old Andy Hall. He's only started once before. His best finish was a 19. They will be the 21st canoe to cross the finish line. They are sponsored by Brulette HVAC. 58-year-old Kevin is an HVAC contractor. Andy, 49, is a general contractor.
Hey, guys.
That is from Swansea, Massachusetts.
Can I get you guys to hang out on the beach until they get here? So us press guys
and
don't have everybody in our way.
Flags.
Thank you.
So this is great. Kevin is going to cross for the first time ever, so we got to make some noise for Kevin Moss finishing this race for the first time ever. His first start and his first finish. Kevin Moss, Andy Hall, the Massachusetts Massachusetts boys, but let's make them feel Michigan welcome as they come across the finish line. That's canoe number 80, our 21st canoe to cross the finish line. And Kevin, congratulations on your first ever finish. Canoe number 80, Kevin Boss Andy Hall, our 21st canoe to cross the finish line. Oh, we got some canoes coming our way. I think those two are unofficial canoes, but I think we got an official one heading this way too.
Oh, there's one coming through. That's some like just people canoeing.
Check it out. All right. There we go. That's the canoe coming around the corner there. Here they come. Heading for home. Yeah, don't be confused by those yellow ones out there. That's our 22nd canoe to cross the finish line. That is canoe number 14. Woo! I hear some noise out there. It's an all-Michigan team. That's 47-year-old David Teddy of Dexter and 59-year-old Bill Taranjo of Grayling. Hey, Bill is working towards his titanium paddler this year. Bill finished second in his previous races, so he knows all about this. They are master's class in all Michigan. They are sponsored by Hall Construction. David is a community education director for Dexter Schools. Bill is currently unemployed, but they're both paddlers right now. And here they come. They will be our 22nd team to cross the finish line. Canoe number 14, ready to take the checkered flag, our 22nd canoe. David Teddy, 47 from Dexter. Bill Taranjo, 59 from Grayling. Congratulations on your 22nd place finish, the AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Woo! Now we got a race on our hands. There's a battle for 23rd and 24th. All right, with a slight lead there, that is canoe number 46. That is Paul Only and Michael Fries. They are just ahead of canoe number 39, Brandon Stafford and Andrew Condi. They make their way toward the finish. That's an all-New York team, 46. Paul, 58 from Westernville. Michael, also from Westernville. Looks like they will be our 23rd canoe to cross the finish line, and right behind them.
Just pull that one stern back up.
Brandon Safford from Texas and Andrew Cundy from Texas. Congratulations on your finish. Woo! 23rd and 24th.
Yo, man, made it.
He gets some numbers on them. Our 23rd place team. We're sponsored by Only the
Christmas Tree
and Gallagher's Sports Bar and Grill. And they were a senior team. Paul, 58, a stonemason from Westernville, New York. And Michael, 16, a retired MD, also from Westernville, New York. So congratulations to both of them on their 23rd place finish. And then the 24th team across, they were a couple of Texas boys. They were sponsored by C2 Group and Gallagher Sports Bar and Grill. Brandon Stafford, 36, a firefighter and paramedic. Thank you for your service, by the way, from Nursery, Texas. Oh, and it was his first finish. So, Brandon, congratulations on your first finish. Oh, so I seen that earlier. Congratulations on finishing that race for the first time. Andrew Condi, 36, a building consultant from Martindale, Texas. Congratulations. You guys were the 24th team to cross the finish line. They are coming hot and heavy. And we got another one just around the bend. All right, and we've got some unofficial paddlers coming to the finish line. Congratulations on your unofficial finishes. You can take the checkered flag, though. But behind you, we got some brothers paddling their way toward home. This is canoe number 74. Couple of more Massachusetts brothers. Canoe number 74, that's Seth Miller, 54, and Stephen Miller, 56. They are sponsored by Family and Cosmetic Dentistry of Grayling. Oh my God, Seth, 54, a personal care assistant from Norwood, Massachusetts. Steven, 56, an engineer from Groton, Massachusetts. Their best finish previously was 26th. We're just going to beat that. They are going to be our 25th canoe to come across the finish line. Here they come. Brothers doing well again. Hey, that sibling rivalry, not happening here. Couple of Massachusetts boys, let's give them a warm Michigan welcome at the finish line. 15 plus hours after starting off in Grayling. And they are also a senior team, too. So congratulations on another senior team crossing the finish line. Seth and Stephen Miller will be our 25th team to cross the finish line. Congratulations on your top 25 finish at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. They are coming hot and heavy, and if you're looking downriver, you'll see another one swinging out of the curve. They will be our 26th canoe to cross the finish line. We got a local boy in this one. That's canoe number 57 coming towards home. That is 61-year-old John Webb, retired teacher from right here in Oscoda. And Dan Mecklenburg, 59, from Columbus, Ohio. They will be our 26th team to cross the finish line. They are sponsored by Vinny's Do It Best of Oscoda and Alcona Canoe, and another seniors team to cross the finish line. Dan is an ecological engineer at Ohio State University. Out of Columbus, 59, best finish 39. John, a retired teacher from Oscoda, best finish of 15th combined. They are going to be our 26th team. And our first truly local boy to do well. Here they come. Our 26th canoe across the finish line. That is canoe number 57. Dan Mecklenburg and John Webb. Here they come. Another senior team doing well. Dan Mecklenburg of Columbus, Ohio. John Webb of Oscoda. You are the 26th team to cross the finish line at the 73rd Annual AuSable River Canoe Marathon by Consumers Energy. Congratulations on your 26th place finish. Again, thanks to Consumers Energy, our title sponsor, and our gold panel sponsor, Munson Healthcare of Grayling. Our bronze paddle sponsors, F&B Operations, Grayling Generating Station, Pat LaFontaine Automotive, Northbound Outfitters, Pick and Sons, and Fisher Contracting. And media sponsors, our good friends, 98.5 UPS, the official radio station. Gray Rock is the GPS tracking presenting sponsor and the official finish line station. Merrill Broadcasting, Hits FM and HitsFM.net. I'm Kevin Allen from WKJC's Carol Broadcasting, and providing all the sound this afternoon, sound effects by Rex.
I heard you had an hour and a half sprint at the end.
Yeah.
All right, come on, y'all, cap it up.
Go over to the finish line for a minute and watch them come across the finish line.
Yeah.
Yeah. How you doing, man? Good. How you doing? Hey, Kelly. Good to see you.
I heard your name yesterday in Grayling.
Cool. Cool. Hey, great tournament. Fishing tournament. How you doing?
Good,
you're live.
Are you? Huh?
This will be live.
I am.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. Headed over to the finish line to get some people coming across. No, she has her truck. How's the trash pickup go? Hey, Vinny.
How are you?
Good. Okay. Well, the record was broken. Hey, Marissa. I don't remember what I said. Oh, the record.
All right. We got one coming the right way, one going the wrong way, but our 27th canoe making their way to the finish line. That's
pretty
canoe
decent
number
crowd.
10.
A lot of the canoes have come in.
And we've got an iron paddler in there also. That is 37-year-old Joe Loosby and 37-year-old Rob Shadley. They are sponsored by Michigan Gutter Incorporated, a horizontal overhead door. Joe, 37, is an HR assistant for Michigan Gutters out of Traverse City. He's finished
hey, Mike,
nine times previously,
you.
Which means this is an iron paddle year for him. Rob Shadley, 37, is the owner of Horizon Overhead Door from Cass City. He's only started twice before. His best finish of 58th. He's going to beat that by quite a bit. Here they come. They will be our 27th canoe across the finish line. Here they come, canoe number 10. Joe Loosby and Rob Shadley and all the Michigan team heading toward home. Congratulations on your top 30 finish. Joe Loosby, Rob Shadley, congratulations on your 27th place finish at the 73rd annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
Got a time clock this year.
Man, we got a couple of them coming up close. First up there. Leading the way is a father-son team from Bay City. That's canoe number 35. Woo! Ryan Childs and Zachary Childs. Zachary just 19 years old, making his way towards the finish line. And hot on their tails is another mixed team in 29. That is Brian Jones and Gwen Hills. Texas people making their way towards the finish line. Brian and Zachary are sponsored by Johnny Green Company and Shattered Shirts, both out of Bay City. Zachary's a student. Brian is a contractor. And they are also the first youth team to cross the finish line. Father and son will finish 28th. Congratulations to the Childs, Brian and Zachary, on your 28th place finish at the 73rd annual Consumer Center for the South River Canoe Marathon. 64 and Jeremiah May 44. They are sponsored by Grayling Restaurant and Finley's Riverside Cabins. Greg Zolfi is an industrial automation salesman, and Jeremiah is a statistician. Greg from St. Paul, Minnesota's best finish has been 38. Jeremiah from Shoreview, Minnesota's best finish 36. They're both going to do better than that. And they are both master's class also, so congratulations. A couple of masters coming home. And in top 30 finish, Greg Zolfi and Jeremiah May. The Minnesota boys are in finish 20th place. Congratulations, gentlemen. And your finish of the 73rd annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. But wait, there's more. All right, it is time. Don't forget Consumers Energy, they got their booth out here. Go get your tickets and tickets. We got some good stuff. Get your souvenirs too for the Canoe Marathon. Also, we've got the cheerleaders out here from Oscoda School. And the class of 2023. Our 31st place canoe is going to be our first all-rookie team. So we got to make some noise. And a couple of Wisconsin boys. That is 50-year-old Dan Goltz and 40-year-old Judson Steinbach. Both are going to finish the race for the very first time. They are sponsored by Green Street Partners of Higgins Lake. Dan, 50, is a wildlife biologist from Verulka, Wisconsin. Judson is a landscaper from La Crosse. And they are going to finish the race for the very first time. Yeah, we need to make some noise. An all-rookie team and a master's team at that. I believe this will be our first all-rookie team to cross the finish line. So congratulations. I'll keep talking so you can find your way here, but I think you can do it. Dan Goltz, 50, from Verulka, Wisconsin. Judson Steinbach, 40, from La Crosse. Your first ever finish. Let's make some noise for this first all-rookie team to cross the finish line. Let's give a couple of Wisconsin boys a Michigan welcome. Congratulations on your top 40 finish. You are the 31st canoe across the finish line. And our first all-rookie team. And the 73rd annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
I don't know what boat that is. It's got to be a good boat.
I don't know what they're...
What did you do?
Ladies and gentlemen, and just enough time to get a quick swing of water. Here comes our 32nd canoe to cross the finish line. It's, I think, our fourth mixed team. That's canoe number 31 making their way towards home. A couple of more Minnesota folks. That is Brad Kiefer from Falcon Heights, Minnesota, and Kira Stalin from New Brighton, Minnesota. They are sponsored by Bass Lake Paddle Company and The Home Place. Fred, 42, a statistician, his best previous finish, 33rd. Kira, also a clinical researcher, best finish, 33rd. They're going to just beat that. They are going to be our 32nd canoe to cross the finish line. Yeah, you can give them some big applause. The Minnesotans making their way towards home in Falcon Heights in New Brighton, Minnesota. We'll give them again that warm Michigan welcome. Fred Kiefer, 42. And Kira Stalin, 49. Heading toward the finish line, they will be our 32nd team to cross the finish line, our fourth mixed team. to cross the finish line. Congratulations as you take the checkered flag on your 32nd place finish at the AuSable River Canoe Marathon. And again, thanks to our title sponsor, Consumers Energy. Want to thank some other event sponsors, the Time Trials sponsor, Weyerhaeuser, the C1 Express Race presenting sponsor was Orolco. Dash for Cash title sponsor was Consumers Energy. Time Trials presenting sponsor was Home Waters. Also Consumers Energy at 98.5 UPS. And Dash for Cash presenting sponsor, our good friends from Gilbert Strong, just downriver from us there in Oscoda. My name's Kevin Allen from Carroll Broadcasting. We are part of the Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon Radio Network. You can listen in on Hits FM 103.3 and 94.9 and hitsfm.net. And providing all this great sound so you can all hear me all the way down the river. Sound effects by Rex. Our 33rd canoe is sprinting towards the finish line. That is canoe number 70. That is Benjamin Carbutton, 36 from Mancelona, and 37-year-old David Smith from Gaylord. They will be our 33rd canoe to cross the finish line. They are sponsored by Carbutton Legal Services, PLLC, and Gaylord Community Funeral Home and Cremation Service. Benjamin is a teacher and athletic director. Thank you for your service. 36 out of Mancelona. Best finish was 57th. Only one previous start, so congratulations. Both of them. This will only be their second finish. David, 37, is his assistant principal. Thank you for your service out of Gaylord. They will be our 33rd canoe to cross the finish line. Their best finish previously, 57th. So your second finish is an awesome one. Here they come. Benjamin Carbutton and David Smith will be our 33rd canoe. That's canoe number 70 crossing the finish line. Congratulations to another All-Michigan team. Congratulations, gentlemen, on your top 40 finish. The AuSable River Canoe Marathon, sponsored by Consumers Energy. Again, thank you to Nicole and Matt keeping our times here from the Amateur Radio Association and Hungry Howies. And, again, over behind us here, Renew Physical Therapy is helping out with stretching and muscles for all of these paddlers. And I want to thank my wife, Chris, too, who's been taking care of all of the numbers for us here, too. She always does a great job when we're out here. And thank you to all for staying around with us here. We got another canoe coming around the bend. So you know what? Don't go away. Here we go. This will be our 34th canoe to cross the finish line.
Okay.
And another All-Michigan team.
It was pretty crazy looking, record-breaking going on. That was exciting.
And a couple of Ross Cavaners on his canoe number 40 making its way toward the finish line.
I'd like to take this.
That is 67-year-old Brad Mills, a builder from Ross Cavan, and 63-year-old Tim McClure, retired school teacher,
I want to take it
also
down
from Ross Cavan. They will be our first veterans team across the finish line, all Michigan, and Iron Paddlers too. Our first veterans team to cross the finish line, making their way towards the finish. 67-year-old Brad Mills and 63-year-old Tim McClure. Brad, the builder's best finish was 12th. Tim, retired school teacher, thank you. Best finish 17th. They will finish 34th. They are sponsored by Dewey's Auto Repair of Roscommon and Literati Bookstore out there in Arbor. Our first veterans team to cross the finish line. And here they come. Let's make a lot of noise. 67-year-old Fred Mills and 63-year-old Tim McClure. Paddling towards home. 15 plus hours after starting in Grayling. Congratulations, gentlemen, on your top 35 finish. 34th place, canoe number 40. At the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Through a song lately? I don't think so. But with good reason, we got another canoe coming. Our 35th canoe to cross the finish line. That is canoe number 43 heading toward the finish line.
Would you hold this?
That is Mike Buzzy Hartman from Grayling and Sean Casey. Also from Grayling, they're another Masters team, all Michigan. Iron paddlers too. They are sponsored by Rolling Oak Brewery and 98.5 UPS. 45-year-old Mike Buzzy Hardman is a supervisor of Special Ed Northwest out of Grayling. Sean Casey, 43, is a video editor out of Grayling. And Sean Casey says his most memorable experience, he raced with Al Whiting Sr. Mike's best finish, 14th. Sean's 12th. But hey, they're coming in 35th. They've got a top 35 finish. Here they come. That's canoe number 43, Mike Buzzy Hartman and Sean Casey, all Michigan team, making their way to the finish line. You got your cheering section there. Mike and Sean, congratulations on your 35th place finish to AuSable River Canoe Marathon. And right behind them, we got a couple of canoes coming in. That first one is a father-son canoe. That is canoe number 79. The Magos are making their way towards the finish line. That's 59-year-old Doug and 29-year-old Josh. Doug out of Grayling, Josh out of Elk Mound, Wisconsin, making their way towards the finish line. Sponsored by Colin Masonry and Construction of Grayling and Grayling Car Care. Doug and Josh Mago will be our 36th canoe to cross the finish line as they make their way paddling hard. Right behind them will be our first all-women's team. They will be 37. That's Caitlin Miner and Virginia Condy making their way towards the finish line. A couple of Texas girls doing well. But first, hey, congratulations to father-son team. Canoe number 79, Doug and Josh Mago. Congratulations on your 36th place finish. Right behind them, Caitlin Miner, 30, and Virginia Condy, 42, from Texas. They will be our first all-women's team. Give them a big hand. They're sponsored by Grayling Promotional Association. Congratulations to Caitlin and Virginia, our first all-women's team across the finish line, and our 37th team to cross the finish line out of San Marcos and Martindale, Texas, respectively. Congratulations. They are coming fast and furious. It looks like we got our 38th canoe around the bend. Man, oh man, they are coming in fast. Now we've got our first husband and wife team coming to the finish line. They will be our 38 team to cross the finish line. That is canoe number 86. That is Chris Broderson and Emily Broderson. They are from Maple Grove, Minnesota. And they will be our 38th canoe to cross. They are sponsored by Stock Drilling and VAA LLC. Chris, 52, is a structural engineer. Emily, 43, is a forensic nurse. Thank you for your services. As for Chris, only two previous starts. Emily, four previous starts. Best finish was 47th. They're going to beat that. They will be the 38th canoe and our first husband-wife team to cross the finish line. Here they come, Chris and Emily Broderson. From Maple Grove, Minnesota. That's canoe number 86 crossing the finish line. Congratulations to the Brodersons. Paddling hard from start to finish. Congratulations on your top 40 finish. 38th place at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
They need more milk at the finish line. I'm going to see what I can do. You got this for a minute?
Yeah.
We almost got through half a song. There we go, our 39th canoe paddling furiously towards the finish line with a top 40 finish. Another mixed team, I believe our fifth mixed team. That is canoe number 23. We've got our first Floridian and another Canadian. That is Kevin Olson, 34, from Parrish, Florida. And 46-year-old Sylvie Nato from Quebec, Canada, making their way towards the finish line. They are sponsored by Tip and the Mitten Grayling and Flowers by Josie. Kevin's a salesman from Parrish, Florida. Best finish 31st. Sylvie, a police officer in Canada. Best finish 34th. Sylvie Nato and Kevin Olson making their way towards the finish line. They will have a top 40 finish, our 39th canoe to take the checkered flag. Here they come. Kevin Olson and Sylvie Nato are ready to take the checkered flag as our 39th canoe, our fifth mixed team. Congratulations to Kevin and Sylvie on your top 40 finish at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
I think they wanted to.
most made it through that one. All right, so like we like to say in radio, it's the top 40. We have our 40th team coming to the finish line. Another mixed team, that is canoe number 87, making their way toward the finish line. And it's another all-Texas team. Texas well represented here today. That is 41-year-old Nathan Tart and 38-year-old Shannon Isidore. They are sponsored by Matt LaFontaine Chevrolet Buick GMC and the Grayling Generating Station. Nathan, 41, father of two awesome kids, is from Driftwood, Texas. Shannon Isendorf, 38, a real estate agent from Dripping Springs, Texas. Nate's best finish was 30th. Shannon's best finish, 67. So she's going to do much better. And they're going to be our 40th canoe to cross the finish line. All Texas, but let's give them a warm Michigan welcome as they come to the finish line just over 16 hours after leaving Grayling. That is Nathan Tart and Shannon Isendorf. Texans crossing the finish line as our 40th team. Here they come, a top 40 finish for Nathan and Shannon. Congratulations on your top 40 finish. Nathan and Shannon from Texas at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. And want to thank some more of the sponsors. Site sponsors include Consumers Energy. They're out here today. Panrod's AuSable Canoe and Kayak, Ray's Barbecue Brews and Blues, also by Old AuSable and by Sushi Chiropractic. Thank you to all the fine sponsors and to you for staying out here with us. Again, don't forget, Consumers Energy has a booth out here. So does the AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Now you can pick up your souvenir t-shirts. They got everything over there. The Oscoda High School cheerleaders are here. They are doing face painting. Yeah, let's go to class of 2023. They are still out here. We've got Sean Clark from State Farm, one of our fine sponsors. The Oscoda Lions are selling raffle tickets. And also out here today, we've got the Heritage Coast Sailing and Rowing. They've got some raffle tickets for sale, too. So take those all in between canoes. I think we actually have a chance to rest. My name's Kevin Allen from WKJC Carroll Broadcasting. We are a part of the AuSable River Canoe Marathon Radio Network. And providing all of the sound today, sound effects by Rex. Towards the finish line, and that is canoe number 21. Indeed, an all-Michigan team. That is Brandon Girardi of Wyoming, Michigan, and Steve Leppard of Kalamazoo, making their way towards the finish line. They are a master's team also, so another master's team coming to the finish line. Brandon, 41, is a physical therapist. So I guess he was ready for this. Steven, also a physical therapist, is 46. Best finishes, 36th for both of them. Today will be our 41st canoe across the finish line. They are sponsored by Drs. Brausa and Bajic, Anglin Foot Associates, and the Rival Group at Firestar Real Estate. Ken Jordy, 41, Stephen Leppard, 46, from Wyoming and Kalamazoo, respectively, will be our 41st canoe to cross the finish line. And here they come. Congratulations to Brandon and Steven as they take the checkered flag. That's canoe number 21. Yeah! Our 41st canoe across. Congratulations, gentlemen, and your time finish at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. And hey, I want to thank the Girl Scouts. I didn't know they were out here, but you can buy Girl Scout cookies. So, Girl Scout Strong, you can start your adventure at gshom.org. Girl Scouts of America. Hey, they are out here selling cookies, so help support the local Girl Scouts. And hey, thank you for the cookies, indeed. Again, make sure to check them out and all the other fine folks we have out here today, too. And again, want to thank some more of our fine sponsors. That would include Real Estate One of Oscoda, Spikes Keg and Ales, Springs Window Fashions, State Farm of Oscoda, Sean Clark, who's out here today. Super 8 of Grayling, Travis Sanitation, Truly Yours Signs and Shirts, Way on Carpet and Furniture Hour, still waiting on Keith, he's out there. Couronne Community Bank and Renew Physical Therapy, they are out there right now, helping out with all of our paddlers as they come in. And we are ready for another paddlers, speaking of that.
If we were trying to make these, we'll have to get a rushing.
Yeah, here I hear the call me by
thank you. Oh, well, this one's kind of special to me. Because coming around the bend is canoe number 98. And one of those two paddlers is from Chicago, Illinois, my hometown. Here they come. Canoe number 98. That is Levi Cornelli, Levy Cornelli, I want to get that right, Levy Cornelli, a packaging engineer from Chicago, and Garrett Garner, a project manager from Traverse City. They are sponsored by Corpac and by the winery at Young Farms. Levi, 26, Garrett, 24. This will be Garrett's first ever finish, so let's give him a big round of applause. First ever finish for 24-year-old Garrett. As for Levi, maybe he has been 49th before. So we've got Levy Cornelli of Chicago, Illinois, and Garrett Garner of Traverse City. They will be our 42nd canoe to cross the finish line. Congratulations to Levy and Garrett. One of my hometown boys doing well. Congratulations on finishing 42nd. Levy and Garrett at this 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
Oh,
All right, our second all-women's team is making their way towards the finish line. We must know who it is. Miss Canoe number 72. That is Lydia Hillscamp from Austin, Texas, and Molly Binion from Martindale, Texas. The Texas girls coming their way towards the finish line. This will be Lydia's first ever finish. Awesome. They are sponsored by New Moon. Lydia, 29, is a marketing and events manager. Molly, 38, is a realtor. As for Molly, she's only had one previous start. She finished a 67th. So they are going to do much better. They are going to finish 43rd. Here they come. Lydia Hillscamp from Austin, Texas. First ever finish in the Canoe Marathon. Molly Binion, 38. This will be just her second finish in the race. Here you go, for the ladies from Texas, Lydia and Molly. For Lydia, first ever finish of the marathon. Paddling hard 16 plus hours after leaving Grayling. More importantly, they're finishing. Canoe number 72, Lydia Hillscamp, Molly Binion, Texas Cows. There you go. Congratulations on your 43rd place finish. Nice job. Good paddling at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. They are our second all-women's team, and they are all women. We raise them right in Texas. Woo. Close on the heel of the Texans. We've got another all-Michigan team. That's canoe number 67 paddling hard towards home. They will be our 44th canoe across the finish line. That is Roy Sowersby from Dearborn Heights and Bruce Damon from Pike Lake.
He was in rough shape.
They are sponsored by Mod Heaters.
Kyle Stonehouse.
Roy, 60, is an engineering technologist. And Bruce, a nurse practitioner, 52. They are a seniors team also. So congratulations, another seniors team coming in. As for Roy, his best finish of 47th. Bruce, a 44th. He's going to match his best ever. They are both coming in. Roy from Dearborn Heights. Bruce from Pike Lake. Going to be our 44th. And another all-Michigan team and a seniors team across the finish line. There they come, canoe number 67, Roy and Bruce. Congratulations, canoe number 67 on your 44th place finish. Nice job. Way to finish the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Been a Texas invasion. We have got our 45th team paddling towards home. It's an all-rookie team and an all-women team. Our first of that this afternoon. That is canoe number 96. That is Cecily Boogie from Buffalo Gap, Texas, and Holly Orr from Martindale, Texas. This will be their first ever finish of the Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. They are sponsored by Aaron Raymond, Century 21 Northland, and Coffee by Steph. Cecily's 21, she's a student. Holly's 38, she is self-employed. And again, this will be their first ever finish. So let's give them a big Michigan welcome as we've got our first all-rookie all-women's team. They will be our 45th team to cross the finish line, and they are all Texas. Cecily Boogie, Holly Orr, Texas gals going to finish 45th. Here they come. Give them a big all-Michigan welcome. Cecily and Holly, congratulations on your 45th place finish, your first ever finish of the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Nice job, ladies. Woo!
I think they pulled out. Oh, no, they took an hour nap.
Took an hour nap?
That's what I heard. Nicole was feeling rough and she took a little nap. Well, who knows how long she needed to catch her breath, I guess.
All right. Once again, hey, want to thank some fine sponsors, including our title sponsor, Consumers Energy. They've been doing it for a long, long time. You can count on them, obviously. They got stuff still set up there. You still get your picture taken there. I love that. The gold panel sponsor, Munson Healthcare, Grayling Hospital. The bronze sponsors, F&B Operations, Grayling Generating Station, Matt LaFontaine Automotive, Pick & Sons, Fisher Contracting, and Northbound Outfitters. And the media sponsors, 98.5 UPS, they are the official radio station. Hits FM is the official finish line station. And Gray Rock, the GPS tracking presenting sponsor. And thanks to our friends, Consumers Energy, for the t-shirts. All right, canoe number 11 paddling their way towards the finish line. There's another all-Michigan team. Yeah! We got some 11s out there. I hear them. That's 47-year-old Robert Smith from Grayling. And 30-year-old William Fowler, also from Grayling. Yes! They are sponsored by Pine Lumber Company of Millersburg. And Energy Services. And they, oh, I love the Hunter Orange there. That's nice. Robert is a bicycling mechanic, and William is a Roco fire technician and a staff sergeant, Army National Guardsman. Hey, thank you for that service.
Let's go, Willie!
As for William, only one previous finish. As for Robert, 11 previous finishes, and here they come. They will be our 48th team across the finish line. Robert Smith, William Fowler, canoe number 11, congratulations on your 48th place finish. The AuSable River Canoe Marathon presented by Consumers Energy.
Thank you.
all night.
That mean that I made with about the organizers of the race is, you see how it feels.
Yes.
Feel like you deserted the desert island in a plane crash.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, our next canoe, our another brothers team heading toward home. That is canoe number 28. That is 35-year-old Alan Putnam from Linden, Michigan. And his brother, 37-year-old Aaron Putnam from Clifford, Michigan. All Michigan team, they are sponsored by ControlNet. And we build databases. Alan, 35, is the branch manager at ControlNet from Linden. This will be his first ever finish. As for Aaron, 37, he works for General Motors. One previous start, his best finish is 62nd. They're both going to do better than that. They are going to be our 46th canoe to cross the finish line. And then we got another one right behind them. First, let's welcome them in. Pair of brothers, Alan and Aaron Putnam, as our 46th canoe across the finish line from Linden and Clifford, Michigan, and all Michigan team. Congratulations. Putnam's all you. We did a great job. Congratulations. Right behind you there, the 47th canoe across the finish line is canoe number 6. That is Mike Packard from Oneonta, New York, and Jake Rapser from Oneonta, New York. They are sponsored by EmbraceTheRace.com on the Saratoga, New York. Mike, 57. And Jake, 23. This will be Jake's first ever finish. So congratulations to Jake Crotcher on finishing for the first time ever. Yeah! We love that. 47th place. Not a bad finish for the first time. Mike, 57th. His best finish was 9th. As for Jake, as mentioned, his first ever finish. Congratulations to Mike Packard and Jake Protzer as they crossed the finish lines in 47th place. They were a mentor team, too, by the way. Yep. Our 48th canoe, paddling hard, is another all-Michigan team. That is canoe number 53. That's Christopher Cray from Grayling and John Braven, 31 from Ross Common, making their way towards the finish line. They are sponsored by Sky High Gymnastics Center and the Don Messer Auto Group. Christopher, 30, is a construction manager out of Grayling. Sean, 31, is an auto salesman out of Ross Common. They are making their way towards the finish line. Here they come. They will be our 48th canoe to cross the finish line. Canoe number 53, Christopher Cray and Sean Braben. Ready to cross the finish line. Christopher's best finish, 63rd. Sean's 23rd. And they will be the 48th canoe across the finish line. Congratulations to Christopher and Sean on your 48th place finish. And they're all Michigan team. Canoe number 53. Taking the checkered flag. Congratulations, gentlemen. A great finish to the 73rd annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
Fine, don't worry. Yeah, the old red, white, and blue got tangled up.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are ready for our 49th canoe to cross the finish line. It'll be a top 50. And we got some more Texas people coming our way. That is canoe number 71 making its way towards the finish line. That is Jason Cade, 49 of San Marcos. And Chris Champion, 40, also from San Marcos. That is not canoe number 71. It is canoe number 68. We want to make sure we get it right. Okay, so instead of Texans, they're Virginians. All right. I love it. There we go. Rusty McLean, 62. Lee Duncan, of 46, will be our 49th canoe to cross the finish line. They are sponsored by Mid-Atlantic Paddlers Association and the Hill Street Revival. Rusty, 62, from Chesapeake, Virginia. Lee, 46, from Ivor, Virginia. This will be Lee's first ever finish of the race. So congratulations to Lee, yeah! Rusty has four previous in a 24th place finish. Today will be our 49th canoe across the finish line. Congratulations to Rusty and to Lee, too, for your first ever finish. Congratulations on a top 50 finish at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Here comes our 50th canoe, so it'll be a top 50 finish. That is canoe number 5 making their way toward the finish line. And it'll be a first ever finish for one of the paddlers, Ted Kenyon, 49, from Montville, Connecticut. And that's Pam Fitzgerald, 60, from Scotia, New York. For Ted, this will be his first ever finish for Pam. Her best finish, 55th. She just had two starts previously. And here they come. They are sponsored by the family of Michael Taggart. In memory of him, Ted, 49, a teacher. Pam, 60, is an athletic trainer. But today, they are top 50 paddlers of another mixed crew across. Ted Kenyon, Pat Fitzgerald, congratulations. And for Ted, congratulations on your first ever finish of the AuSable River Canoe Marathon, 50th place. At the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Okay.
got 19th. Yeah. They were on the top 20.
Okay, coming around the bend.
16 hours.
This is a special canoe. This is canoe number 36. They will be our 51st canoe to cross the finish line. But not just that, but Michael Guerin, Crazy Mike, is now going to set the record for most consecutive finishes. That's awesome. Canoe number 36, that's Zach Cheney, 24 from Livonia, and Michael, Crazy Mike Guerin, 63 from Washington Township, Michigan. So we got an all-Michigan team. They are sponsored by North Country Corner and Vic's Pit Stop Barbecue and Pizza. All Flint, they will be our 51st canoe across. As for Zach, only one previous start, 46th place finish. Michael, 25 starts. His best finish, 19th, but this will be the record for most, well, this is a day of records, for most consecutive starts. Here they come. 51st canoe, that's canoe number 36. Zach Cheney of Livonia. Michael Crazy Mike Guerin from Washington Township. All Michigan. Zach is an actuarial analyst, and Michael is a retired clinical engineer, but today they are both paddlers. Canoe number 36. Crossing the finish line in 51st. Congratulations, Michael, on most consecutive finishes of the race. And congratulations to you and Zach on finishing. You got a 51st place finish. Congratulations at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. And right behind them in 52nd place, this is a canoe with the oldest combined age. They are 52nd. That is Nick Lysik, 77, and Peter Heed, 71. Yeah, we got to make some noise for them. Canoe number 56. Nick from Orange, Massachusetts, and Peter from Keene, New Hampshire. Oldest combined, and Nick will also get his iron paddle this time around. Congratulations. He is 52nd. Nick Lysik. Peter Heed, 52nd. Congratulations, gentlemen. That was awesome. Nick from Orange, Massachusetts. Peter from Keene, New Hampshire, the oldest combined age. And Nick, congratulations on your iron paddler. Right behind them in 53rd is another husband and wife team. That is canoe number 73. Wade Binion, 42, and Samantha Binion, 35, from Granbury, Texas. They are sponsored by the Honorable Monty J. Burmeister and Wendell Smith Insurance. 53rd place, Wade 42 from Granbury. Samantha Binion 35 from Granbury. And this will be Samantha's first ever finish. So congratulations to Samantha. Wow, husband and wife team. 53rd place, nice job at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. I'm not catching my breath at all. 54th place, right behind it's more Texas people. That is canoe number 71. Now we got 71. Jason Cade, 49, from San Marcos, and Chris Tannen, 40, from San Marcos. This will be Chris's first ever finish, and for Jason, only his second. Here they come. I love it.
Yay.
My family and cosmetic dentistry in Grayling. Jason Cade. Chris Champion, San Marcos Texans. You are the 54th team to cross the finish line. Congratulations on a great finish for the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Right behind them, woo, our 55th team and our 56th team. Let's start with 55. That is canoe 15, mixed team. Rodney Elliott from Grayling and Rebecca Sutter from Jay, New York. Man, oh man. Best finishes, 49th and 35th. They will be the 55th team to cross. Rodney, 54. Rebecca, 52. Sponsored by North Star Auto Wash and doTERRA by Nicole Ligrich. Congratulations to Rodney and Rebecca on your 55th place finish. Nice job, Rodney and Rebecca, on your finish. The Canoe Marathon, a mixed team crossing, and another mixed team behind you, the 56th team. That is canoe number 47, Jeff DeFeo, 66, from Huntington, Massachusetts, and Katie Beck, 26, from New York. Katie's first ever finish again. All right, another rookie. Congratulations, Jeff, 66. Katie, 26, she's a school teacher and her first ever finish. Congratulations. Jeff from Huntington, Massachusetts. Katie from New York, New York. They are sponsored by Pokia Designs, Outrigger Canoes, and Pickett Sons of Grayling. Wow. 56th place team right there. Congratulations to them. Again, want to thank some more of our contributing sponsors, Hart Motors, Huntington Bank, Instacote, Kodiak Group, Medicine Shop, Northland Area Federal Credit Union, Oscoda CBB,
Oscoda,
Paddle Hard Brewery, and Profiles.
Live!
And, thanks to, again, Consumers Energy, our title sponsor. We've got still some groups here. You can still get your merchandise. The merchandise stand's still open. I believe the Girl Scouts are still here, too, selling cookies. Thank you for the cookies. And we do have, looks like the cheerleaders are still doing it. They are still face painting, and you can come on over and do that. Sean Clark is still here. Looks like they're still selling raffle tickets from Heritage Coast Sailing and Rowing. And right down the line there, too, I think the Lincoln, the Oscoda Lions. But I see some other people down there, too. But come on over this way if you'd like. And make sure you take in what's happening here. Hey, we've got some in-between time here. Again, my name's Kevin Allen from WKJC. We are from Carroll Broadcasting, part of the Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon Radio Network. And the man supplying all the sound effects by Rex this afternoon. And you know it, just as I get done talking, we got another canoe coming in. It will be our Heinz 57 canoe. We have got canoe number 84 making its way towards the finish line. That is 49-year-old Nate Winkler from Traverse City. And 61-year-old Jaya Ellison from Burlington, Wisconsin. They are sponsored by River Park Campground of Grayling. They are a mixed team and a master's team. Nate is a fish biologist and a wildland firefighter. Thank you for that. Jaya is a yoga instructor. She's probably going to need some of that after this. Nate, 49, best finish, 28th. As for Jaya, 4 previous starts, her best finish of 52nd. We've got another mixed crew coming across the finish line. They will be our 57th team to cross the finish line. Here they come. 49-year-old Nate Winkler of Traverse City and 61-year-old Jaya Ellison from Burlington, Wisconsin. This is canoe number 84. Nate will be the 57th canoe to cross the finish line. Here they come. Paddling hard some 16-plus hours after leaving Grayling. Nate and Jaya, congrats. On your top 60 finish at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon, 57th place. Another mixed team coming around the corner. They will be our 58th team to cross the finish line. They are also a senior team. This is canoe number 58. And again, finishing 58. And some more Minnesotans. We have got Michael Davis, 51, from New Hope, and Neil Harberts, 62, from St. Paul. They are sponsored by Stock Drilling and Weyerhaeuser, one of our sponsors. Michael, 51, is in hotel sales. Neil, 62, a retired French kinder teacher. Be another mixed team across the finish line. Michael, best finish was 50th. EO, best finish 45th, but I just noticed EO will also get her Iron Paddle Award this time. She is an Iron Paddler. It'll be her 10th finish. So congratulations to E.O. Harbert and Michael Davis. As they come across the finish line, they will be our 58th canoe and another mixed crew crossing the finish line. Michael and E.O., take that checkered flag and congratulations to E.O. Iron Paddler this year. I love it. Congratulations, Canoe 58, on your 58th place finish. We've got some more brothers coming to the finish line. Oh, and a local boy, too, from Curran. These are the Kelloggs making their way towards the finish line. They will be the 59th canoe across. That's canoe number four, 38-year-old Josh Kellogg of Couronne and 35-year-old Jeremy Kellogg of Plainwell, Michigan. They are sponsored by Kellogg Ridge Grocery Store and Blue Collar Clothing. Josh, 38, a system engineer in Couronne. Jeremy, 35, a mechanical estimator. 49th, the best finish for Josh. 52nd for Jeremy. They will be 59th. Brothers doing good. Canoe number four, congratulations on your 59th place finish. It's a familiar name right there in canoe racing. Josh and Jeremy Kellogg, congratulations.
I'm about crying, tired.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, well, I can read you some more fine sponsors, including AuSable Eye Care, AuSable Hardware, Century 21 of Grayling, Charlie's Country Store, CSI Emergency Apparatus, Deer Bear Brewery, Du Bois Lumber, BD4, Dairy Oil, and Grayling Visitors Bureau. And we have another canoe coming around the bend. This will be our 60th canoe of the afternoon. And another local boy from Mayo, Michigan, making his way towards the finish line. That is canoe number 50. Chris Ecker, 57, from Mayo. And Bill Mahaffey Jr., 40, from Grayling. All Michigan and all Masters class, too. They are sponsored by CanoeRaceWorld.com and Camping World, the Houghton Lake. Chris, 57, a manager at Camping World, out of Mayo. Only two previous starts, his best finish of 46th. Bill, 40, is an insurance claim supervisor in Grayling. His best finish, 49th.
I wish you could find a place to put this.
Combined, they will be our 60th canoe to cross the finish line.
Stationary.
I think we're 17 plus hours. Well, our previous canoe finished in 16:44:37, so we're still plus sub 17 hours. And here they come. Our 60th canoe to cross the finish line. Top 60 finish. Chris Ecker, 57, from Mayo. Bill Mahaffey Jr., 40, from Grayling, all Michigan and all Masters. Here they come. Canoe number 50 will be our 60th canoe to cross the finish line. Yes, gentlemen. Chris and Bill, congratulations on a great finish of the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon.
Keep coming in, it's hard to stop.
Yes, indeed. They're coming hot and heavy. It's an all Michigan team, once again, our 61st team to cross the finish line. And we got another rookie making his way to the finish line. It's an all Michigan team. It's David Hawkins, 39, from Grayling. Yes, it's canoe 42. Yeah, we got some 42s out here. And Ryan Barris, 44, from Grayling. They are making their way towards the finish line. David, 39, is the territory manager. This will be his first ever finish. Ryan Barris, 44, has had three previous starts. His best finish, 41st. But they are coming across the finish line as our 61st canoe. And the first ever time for David Hawkins, 39. So let's make it special for him. David Hawkins, 39. We are 61st canoe across the finish line, and for David, his first ever, so make it special. There they come. Canoe number 42, we got a cheering section going, gentlemen. David and Ryan, congratulations on your 61st place finish at the 73rd Annual Consumers Energy AuSable River Canoe Marathon. Hey again, my name's Kevin Allen. I am from Carroll Broadcasting, who along with Hits FM, we are the official finish line station. 98.5 UPS, the official overall radio station And again, Grayrock is the official GPS tracking station. And again, my name's Kevin Allen from WKJC. And again, providing all this great sound so you can hear me all the way up around the bend. Sound effects by Rex. Call him at 736-9564 if you need some great sound.
Check out on the live. Well, I need to take a break and take a look at some things and
what do you want to do?
Show in the audience. We're tired and need to take a little break. I hope you enjoyed what we've brought to you so far here at the finish line. And look for the results online. And thank you all for tuning in. Have a good night.